submerged, so that we have floaties like we had last time.
Yeah. It's Joni, she's always 15 minutes late.
I started photographing water, I guess the early 90s. And I never even photographed a human being outside of the water until I went digital in 2008. And I never really gave it any thought until a buddy of mine photographs a lot of glam. He approached me about doing some of this stuff for some of his glamour models and stuff like that. That's when we started doing this. And I mostly do this just for fun. If your battery's fine, your cards aren't full, everything's hunky-dory, don't. Because these things, it's like, all it takes is a piece of lint, all it takes is a hair, a piece of sand, like that, getting one of the O-rings, and it makes it clean. Fortunately, I haven't had a catastrophic flood in a very long time. It's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when it will flood. Most people don't like it when you say that. You gotta lead your life, but you're not sure. The people here have been working for years. And poor Ann here, it's like, she always gets stuck last minute. Hey, do this, do that, you know? And it's like everybody here's done this long enough and they're watching what's going on, watching this and that. You know, they know where the lights should be. I can communicate with them really well. Safety factors are involved. But a lot of times they're watching me too if I get myself in trouble, you know? It does. It does happen.
He holds breath a little too long when he comes up.
It's like Don's not coming up. Yeah, he's kind of prostrate all over the bottom of the pool there. Maybe we should get him out. You know, we come up with a couple of good projects every year. It's a lot of times you just take something that's land based and you stick it in the water. And I've kind of over the years I do spoofs off of different movies and things. We did one a couple of years ago from The Fifth Element, and that turned out really cool. That was a long night. Girl drove in from L.A. and all night got here. Taped her up through in the water and she nailed it. We got lucky with that. Like I said, I'm setting these top side based to where I think the water level is going to be, and then I'll make my adjustments on the way. Because, like I said, this thing is basically just a giant mirror. So anything we fire into it, guess what? Mawson's going to bounce right back up. And that's one of the things that's really cool about photographing in the water is you do have this 800 square foot mirror floating from top of it. And if you look at a lot of the work I do, it's almost all reflecting and stuff in the water. And it really adds a lot. It also lets you indicate the direction of the wall.
All this time, I'd never let you go. There never seemed chains that had kept you in the
So pretty much it is just like normal makeup. I'm going to do what I would normally do. And then we'll just make sure that we seal it for the final part. We do have to make sure that we don't use any hairspray. Any kind of products like that will totally make the water foggy. And I like, a lot of people like to see glitter and stuff like that, a lot of shimmer. You have to be so careful because it will totally ruin the water. So I have to remember not to do that.
The big thing is you want it warm, you want them comfortable, you want them relaxed. Anything you can do to get them calm, get their heart rate down, not using a lot of energy, the better they're going to hold their breath, the better they're going to do. So this whole process is extremely calm. If you've ever looked at like free divers that go down 400 or 500 feet, they lay on the surface and listen to Mozart for 15 minutes and just get everything just chilled out. This process is exactly like that because she's got to hold her breath for, in this case, she's probably going to be good for about 20 or 30 seconds. So, but the calmer she is, the more, especially with the dress, you'll see it. So it's really about being chilled out. Now, when I work with like the professional mermaids, free divers and stuff like that, they outhold me. I have a ballerina I work with, and this girl can go down for like 4 minutes at a time. I'm good for about 30 seconds on a good day. And Jillian's done this enough, she knows. She'll know where the lights are at, she'll stay in the lights. That's a big thing too with like currents and stuff like that. It'll push them out and away. Because this stuff only works in a small area.
You know,
you got 4 feet by 4 feet, and if you're not in that area, it's just simply not gonna work.
I'm down by the fire at the ocean side, just waiting for that underwater world to say goodnight.
Okay, and then so I'll have you do that, and then we'll do some shadow.
The trench coat has a lot of weight to it, and so as soon as it touches the air, it like inflates. It's like an instant life jacket. And so it's like you're trying to go down in the water, and it's just like pulling you back up, so then you have to bring it all out. And it's really heavy, and I could go on and on. We don't like the trench coat, but it is really pretty.
It is cool.
Yeah.
It is cool.